A switch doesn't just turn on and off a light. In networking, a switch is a vital networking component. We're gonna learn about that now. Hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell. A switch is a piece of networking infrastructure. It's a networking device that moves traffic for us, for on a network. When data comes into a port, and remember, in this case, we're talking about a physical port on the device, on the switch, it makes a decision. It says, where is that going? What is the destination MAC address? It looks in the packet, in the data, and says, okay, there's a destination to that. I'm going to send it out one of my ports, could be one of 10 ports or one of, you know, hundreds in some switches. Which port does that need to go out of? So really all a switch is doing is intaking information, data, taking it, moving it to another place. Think about, you know, some sort of like really cool robot that takes in mail or packages. Okay, I have that, that's going at least out that way. And by the way, when it goes out that way, that doesn't mean it's its final destination. Switches can have layers upon layers. We've talked about access layer and distribution layer and core layer. So a core switch may say, okay, I know that goes that way. And it sends it down a wire that direction, but where it ends up, maybe to another switch, not only maybe, is likely, it's going to be to another switch. And that switch will take that and say, okay, well, I know more specifically where that's going, it's gonna go here. And then maybe the access layer switch says, oh, I have that coming in, it's gonna go to Sam sitting over there. So the switch moves data based on MAC address. It doesn't do it based on IP address. It knows MAC addresses, and that's how it moves information. Another function of a switch is something called VLANs. So we learned about the term LAN, a local area network. A virtual LAN, it's a way to identify physical ports on a switch and say, okay, this port is VLAN 10. And maybe the first 10 ports are VLAN 10. So we're all gonna participate in VLAN 10. And maybe the next 10 ports are VLAN 20, the next 10 are VLAN 30. But just know that it's a grouping of devices at the network level. Why would you do that? Why would you ever just group them? Why not just let a switch do its thing? Well, there's kinds of traffic out there called broadcast and multicast traffic. If I say, hey, Sam, I'm gonna get his attention. But if I say, hey, everybody in the room, now I'm going to get the attention of all of the people. If I say, hey, everybody, lunch is served, A, I'm leaving, I'm gonna be the first guy in line, but B, that's an announcement for everybody. Not a big deal. We don't do that a lot in person. We're not yelling to a bunch of people. In networking, broadcast traffic is very essential, but it also can be very deadly to a network. Imagine there's so many broadcasts. If you have a core switch with distribution switches, with access layer switches, and one person sends a broadcast message, one phone, one laptop sends a broadcast message, who's gonna hear that? If you don't have control over that, or you can't segment that, literally thousands upon thousands of devices can hear that broadcast message. And then all of a sudden you think exponentially, if everyone has some broadcasts, eventually broadcasts can actually bring down a network. For every network outage there is, broadcast storms or high broadcasts is a reason for it. So VLANs help us control who hears messages like broadcast and multicast messages. A virtual LAN is let's cut it up into little pieces so maybe so we can have it segregate or segment different sets of people and things based on, you know, the accounting department, engineering department, HR, they can have their own VLANs for certain reasons. The last thing I need you to know about what a switch can do, this is a simple thing. Switches can provide power. And by power, I don't mean power, I mean electricity. They can actually have electricity come out of their ports. Why would you do that? Well, a lot of phones today, if you have a phone on your desk that you can pick up and dial and it works, that's likely powered over Ethernet. It's called PoE, power over Ethernet. So the copper cable that goes through your network actually can carry electricity. Wireless access points are another good example. Wireless access points today, In your home, you're plugging them into your wall. In a real big network, we don't plug them in at all. Most of them actually don't even have a place to plug them in. They get power over the Ethernet line. Fiber is light, that can transmit data. It can't transmit power. Why? It's going through over glass. It's an insulator. So copper is always going to happen inside of a network because it also can carry power. It actually makes wiring much easier. Imagine you have to put 100, 200,000 access points in your buildings and you had to have an outlet for each one of them. The cost is crazy to do that. But if we can carry that power, that electricity over Cat 6 cable, copper cable, that's great. So we've talked about phones and access points. Another are security cameras, IoT devices now, thermostats. There are number of devices that have to, that their responsibility is to consume power, or part of how they power is via Ethernet, power over Ethernet. Just a consideration that a lot of times when you purchase a switch, you actually need to look at how much power it can output. Does it have what, you know, the power capacity to power all the devices that you need? But I think hopefully that's good. So that's basic switch operation, how it divert, you know, how it moves traffic, how you can segment traffic with VLANs, and how you power devices with PoE. Hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell. Thanks for watching, and keep on learning.